Good morning friends, and this is a Hyundai Grand i10 diesel edition and Hyundai Grand i10 sports. And we can first talk about the exterior design, and this is the exterior design. And first let me concentrate to the headlight, and the headlight seems to be nice. And this is halogen light, halogen indicator, and here also you can see halogen fog lights. That seems to be nice, and nice treatment in the air dam. That's a nice treatment in the air dam. Here the symbol is treated by chrome treatment. That also seems to be nice. And at the front, above the hood, you can see nozzles and dual blade wipers. And here you can see what first did me turn on the hazard light. This is hazard switch. Okay, now the hazard light is turned on, but this is not working, so we can go to the another side. Okay, here the light is working, and absolutely stunning lights, I would say. Talking about the wheel size, the wheel size happens to be worse wheel size. All the time I'm forgetting or not seeing the wheel size. Okay, the wheel size happens to be 165, 70 or 14, which means same as, sorry, I can't compare with another cars. This is not a swiping indicator, but also seems to be nice. And here you can see nice beading, and there is no front parking sensors and also front parking camera either. Let me get into the rear seat. Okay, now I am in the rear seat. First let me turn off the hazard light switch and turn on the air conditioning. Okay, the air conditioning is now on. The air conditioning works brilliantly well. And here you can see magazine holders, but no scooped out seat backs. And also here you can see seat belt, and here you can see space to keep stuff, and door pockets are large enough. And here you can see speakers, and here you can see parcel tray. Now I can't open the boot because, but that I will open at the ending of the video. Okay, here you can see parcel tray. Meanwhile, here this is hump, but also three people can comfortably sit in this car. Their hump is not at the heavy side or the largest side or the highest side. Here you can see intercooling. But I think this is not, this in here there will be no working of air conditioning. And let me get outside of the car. Okay, this car has remote keyless entry, and there's a nice touch. Talking about the engine configuration, this is 4-cylinder 16 valve for 1.2 cuppa dual, and this is not cuppa dual, this is 1.2 U2 CRDI diesel motor, and which has 3-cylinder 12 valves, and the configuration is DOHC, and the cubic capacity of this car happens to be 1.2. And talking about the gear lever, the gear lever is 5-speed manual transmission. Talking about the front suspension, it is as ordinary MacPherson strut at the rear, coupled torsion beam axle, and shock absorber is gas type. And talking about the size tires, 165 R14 and steel alloy, for all trims that is available. And the tire is available as tubeless tire. And talking about the dimensions of this car, the overall length happens to be 3765 mm, and the overall width happens to be 1660 mm, and overall height happens to be 1520 mm, and the wheelbase happens to be, okay, here's the wheelbase. Okay, talking about the wheelbase happens to be 2425 mm, and the front track happens to be 1179 mm, and the rear track happens to be 1493 mm. And talking about the fuel tank capacity, the fuel tank capacity happens to be 43 liters. 43 liter fuel tank capacity. Let me get into the rear seat. Okay, now I am in the rear seat, and here this is comfortable. Under the support is nice, and headroom is also nice, and legroom is adequate, I would say. All the things in this car, yes, happens to be nice. Let me get into the driver seat of the car. So the remote keyless entry that I told earlier to you, and while opening the door, here you can see sunroof for the power window and folding the side view mirror that I'll show you now. Okay, the side view mirror can be folded, and here you can see sun visor along with the mirror placement. Here you can see light, and also here you can see nothing but sun visor. You can see there is no light placement at the center. The best competitor of this car happens to be whom? The Maruti Suzuki Swift. Let me show you how much does it the car rev. Okay, it rev mostly. So talking about the design, interior design of this car, the interior design of this car happens to be nice and absolutely stunning. First, let me concentrate to the instrument cluster. In the instrument cluster, you can see rev meter, speedometer, temperature meter, fuel meter. And here you can see trip A, trip B, like that, and overall running kilometer. And that I'll show you. And average fuel meter and all the things happens to be here. Sorry, average fuel, stuff like that. Here you can see 12 volt charging socket, and here you can see aux, and here you can see USB, and this is for air conditioning, and this is for hazard light switch. Yeah, there's here you can see hazard light is working brilliantly well, and this is the control for the light. Okay, there was the control for the light, and to work the wiper. Okay, the spray of the wiper is brilliantly well. It is cleaning even all the muds. Sorry, not all the muds, all the dusty particles. And the power steering of this car happens to be nice. Absolutely no stress. While turning the steering, there is no stress. And here you can see what reset and trip. And there is another steering mounted controls in this. You're looking to here, there is no other steering mounted control, and this is for front, and there is no wipers at the rear. And here also space to keep stuff, and also door pockets that are large enough, you can keep 1 liter bottle, and there is no placement for the glove house. Sorry, I'm kidding. Here space to keep stuff. And this is glove house, and glove compartment also seems to be nice and efficient, elegant, and the gear system also worked very well. Okay, this is in the first gear. Now I'm taking the car. Okay, the car is moving nice and brilliantly well. Okay, here you can see you can keep 1 liter bottle, stuff like that, pin cup holders, and center console feels to be nice, and there is no seat belt alarm, but here it is showing to put seat belt, but there is no alarm for the seat belt. Let me take this car to reverse. Okay, to take this reverse, first you want to lift the gear to up, then yeah, this is the reverse gear. I want to put down the handbrake, and the car all the way closed. Why? What is this happening? Okay, the reverse gear happens to be okay. That's the reverse parking sensors, but there is no reverse parking camera. That's a disappointing matter for this variant, but I think this is the mid variant. Because of that, sometimes this may not have reverse parking camera, but it has a reverse parking sensors. Okay, this is the driving of this car. This has better ride quality, I would say. And the fit finish of this car happens to be nice and efficient, I would say. And the steering also feels to be nice. And this is electrical power steering. And that is very nice to drive. Okay, reverse parking sensor is working brilliantly well, but there is no reverse parking sensor. That's a disappointing matter. Here, I put the gear to first gear. Okay, now I'm driving the car. Okay, the car turned to its initial position. Okay, here, this is the control for the air conditioning, and this is the control for the audio system. Then you play audio right away. Okay, where's the audio? Okay, yeah, this is, here is the audio. Okay, that's audio control, and I will say low audio is in the mid quality, not in the highest position, and that's only about this Hyundai Grand i10. If you guys like this video, you want to do is that subscribe to the channel and also press the bell icon, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram.